Hello students, so basically we have seen what is ecological pyramid, what are food chain, and also we have seen how the food web is important for the human life, right? So today we are going to study the different types of ecological pyramids in detail. And so let us begin with the first ecological pyramid, that is the pyramids of number. Okay, so we have already studied the nutritional relationship between the organisms at different trophic levels, right? So these relationships, they not only involve energy but also the number of individuals and their biomass at each trophic level. So it is possible to graphically represent these relationships, and that is what we call it as what? Ecological pyramids. So basically, in ecological pyramids, producers occupy the base, right? And the different levels of consumers occupy the successive tiers. So thus, most often the territory consumer form the apex of the pyramid, means the top level of the pyramid. So the pyramid, which is constructed based on the number of individuals occupying a given trophic level at a given period of time, is nothing but called as what? The pyramid of numbers. So in most of the ecosystems, for most of the food chains, the pyramid of numbers will be upright. Okay, we will see this, what is upright pyramid. So since the number of individuals at the successive trophic levels keeps on decreasing, so here basically the graphical representation is based on the number of individuals per unit area of various trophic levels, and the large number of producers tend to form the base, and who will form the tip or the top? That is nothing but the top carnivorous animals. Okay, so see, here is the pyramid of numbers, which is at the upright position. Okay, so here basically producers are the plants, then primary consumers are the mice, then secondary are the snake, and the territory consumers are hawk. Okay, see, here are the two types, there are different types of the pyramids based upon the number of pyramids. See, here is the inverted one, or we call it as what? The which is not upright, or inverted type of pyramid. Okay, so see, the pyramid which is constructed based upon the numbers, if you see, here are few numbers of the herbivores, few numbers of the parasites, so few numbers of the hyper parasites, here are producers. So here is the herbivores, which is dependent on the single tree or the single plant, and then the carnivore. Okay, so these are the different type numbers of trophic levels based upon the area. So what happens when you see this food chain? Okay, a pyramid which is constructed taking into view the biomass. Now here we are just considering the numbers. Okay, then next we will see the biomass. Okay, see, so what is pyramid of biomass? It is nothing but the graphical representation of biomass which is present per unit area at different trophic levels, with producers again at the base and the carnivores at the top. But it is calculated here, it is calculated as mass of each individual, which is called as what? X, that is number of individuals at trophic levels. Means here it is the dry weight of all the matter in the organisms at a trophic level. Means we are just taking a dry weight, that is something which is useful in the terms of numbers but which is calculated. Okay, so here the pyramid is constructed taking into view the biomass, which is the dry weight of all the matter in the organisms at a trophic level. It is nothing but called as what? Pyramid of biomass. Okay, so mostly it will be upright, in the upright position, and in few of the aquatic food chains it will be inverted, it may be inverted. See, here is the upright pyramid of biomass in a terrestrial ecosystem, and here is the inverted pyramid in an aquatic ecosystem. You will not have the problems based upon this. Just to know the different kinds of pyramids, we are introducing these three kinds of pyramids. One is the pyramid of numbers, second one is pyramid of biomass. Okay, so here it is given in terms of mass. Here it is 1000 kg, 100 kg, 10 kg, 1 kg. So this is a dry weight. And in terms of aquatic, it is 4 g/m², 8 g/m² and 12 g/m², which is calculated. And the third one is nothing but what? That is called as what? Pyramid of productivity, which is also called as pyramid of energy. Okay. So here the pyramid is constructed on the basis of the amount of energy fixed at each level. Okay, there is some amount of energy which is given by the particular plant or particular animal which is at the different kinds of tropic level. So see, it is a graphical representation of the flow of energy through each tropic level of a food chain over a fixed time of period. And the input of solar energy may be indicated by adding an extra to the base. So here the energy will be calculated at every tropic level, but when the plant captures the solar energy, the energy will become double or more in case of the producers who are at the base. See, this is the pyramid of productivity, which is calculated in terms of energy, and energy is calculated in terms of joule. This is the symbolic formula for joule. Okay, here is the primary producer, this flower or plant, then primary consumer which feeds on the plant, secondary consumer which feeds on the primary consumer, and tertiary consumer who feeds on the secondary consumer. Okay, so in any ecosystem, for any food chain, the pyramid of energy will always be upright. So you have already learned that the amount of usable energy available at each tropic level is only about 10% of energy that is available at the previous tropic level, and this idea is very much in accordance with the laws of thermodynamics. Okay, we will study about thermodynamics in our next class. So we need to study it in detail form. So are you clear about the three types of pyramids? Then we will see how this energy spent is in a usable form and in unusable form. So what happens to the unusable energy? That is we are going to study in terms of the disturbances that are caused in the ecosystem. Okay, these are different kinds of disturbances. So for you in your class, only biomagnification is considered in the syllabus. The rest two are just for your knowledge. So what is bioaccumulation? When plants or animals take up a chemical from the environment and do not excrete it. Okay, what I said, do not excrete it. The chemical builds up in the organism over time to a potentially lethal level. Means this accumulation means what? This energy is completely digested. There is no waste product formed in the bioaccumulation. Then what is biomagnification? Basically what happens in a food chain, it is not just the nutrients that get transferred. What we have seen is energy flows from one tropic level to another tropic level. Means what? The nutrients are transferred from one tropic level to another tropic level. But it is not only the nutrients, but also there are some toxic substances which are getting transferred from one tropic level to another. And in most of the cases, the concentration of toxic substances increases as they pass to the higher tropic levels. Okay, so as it passes to the higher tropic levels, the flow of energy is also in a higher form, right? So energy is also passed in the higher form along with the toxic substances. So such an increase in the concentration of toxic substances or a pollutant with every link in the food chain is called as what? Biological magnification or biomagnification. That is called as what? Biomagnification. Okay, so this results in what? The chemicals in organisms at higher levels in the food chain, and which may not affect the lower levels of the food chain, but the top levels take in so much it can cause disease or even death. That is, so much of toxic substances is given out. So, the most familiar example of biomagnification is the gradual increase in the concentration of DDT. You know DDT powder, right? So, it is the most of the familiar example for all of you. That is, the concentration of DDT in the trophic levels in several food chain will increase. And this indiscriminate use of DDT as an insecticide, especially for eradicating mosquitoes, has now resulted in DDT being detected in the tissue of small fishes and predatory birds because they feed on the producers, right? So DDT has been detected even in mother's milk. That is, so far it is also detected in the mother's milk. So this is how the biomagnification will disrupt the balance in the food chain, and particularly it affects the organisms and mostly at the higher trophic levels. Okay, so here I will show you the diagram for this. We will see the diagram in our next class. I have a simple diagram, or I will share the diagram in the WhatsApp group. Okay, so thank you for watching the video. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can ask me.